I ordered a promotional item for my podcast, and I needed it by a certain date.
When his air fresheners didn't arrive on time, Clay Parker, who happens to be a director here at WCBS, emailed the company. He was told he selected the wrong shipping time, and they could prove it.
Not only can I show you the screen cap of the two-day shipping terms, but I can also show you actually navigating the site during the checkout process. I click on the link, and then lo and behold, here's my mouse on his site, navigating his site. All the text fields, my card information is there, everything, my home address.
That link took him to InspectLet, a third-party site that tracks customers' online purchases and behavior patterns for marketing purposes. InspectLet, along with other tracking sites, Hotjar and Mouseflow, boast big-name clients like Costco, Office Depot, and eBay.
We all understand that our information's out there, but this type of recording of the website and me actually navigating the site just seemed sort of super invasive and creepy to me.
I think it's a lot more common than you'd think.
Cybersecurity expert Siobhan Gorman says online retailers have been tracking consumers for years. These days, nearly every site does it, and the technology is increasingly sophisticated.
Oftentimes, companies will claim that you are voluntarily providing this information to them because you're making a purchase. However, obviously, you can't make the purchase without giving them things like your address and your credit card.
Gorman says these third-party tracking sites are often more vulnerable to hackers and sometimes even sell your data to other companies, which is legal under certain privacy policies. So what's an online shopper to do?
And it's unfortunate that many companies will make it rather difficult to go find how you would opt out of this kind of data collection. But normally there is some mechanism to do it. It's just that it takes a little bit of looking.
So Gorman says, find the privacy policies on your favorite websites and opt out of data collection. This setting is usually at the bottom of a website in fine print, but it's difficult to find, as she mentioned, and it varies from state to state.